Okay, so welcome to our chemical reactions lab. So in this video we're going to be doing 10 chemical reaction demos, and your job is to predict the products and write down any observations for each reaction. So let's get started with the first reaction. Okay, for our first reaction we're going to mix barium chloride with sodium sulfate. So barium chloride is a clear solution. And watch carefully. You can see in the pipette that sodium sulfate is also clear. I'll put a couple drops in there so you can see what happens. So write down some observations and try to predict what products just formed. Okay, for this next reaction we're going to be burning a strip of magnesium, which you can see I'm holding here, and this will be pretty bright. So there we are, burning our magnesium. You can see it produces quite a bit of smoke. And our product is a white powder, which you can kind of see. So you can kind of see our product right here at the end. It's a white solid. Okay. Next off, we're going to do zinc solid, which you can see right there, plus hydrochloric acid. And watch carefully. So it's a slower reaction, I'll let you watch it for a bit. But try to predict the products. You can see bubbles are forming, so write down some observations. In this next well, I'm going to place some sodium carbonate. A couple drops of sodium carbonate. And I'm also going to add some hydrochloric acid. So you can see instantly we get a nice reaction there. Try to predict what gas is forming. Okay, move on to, we are on station 5 now, and we're going to be doing potassium chromate, which is a cool solution. It's got a nice yellow color. And we're going to add some hydrochloric acid again. So watch this one very carefully. And that's a very cool solution. So that one, I'm not going to get you to predict the products. It's a bit more complicated of a reaction, so I wrote the products out for you. But look at the signs of a chemical change. Okay, this next one will be pretty interesting. So we're going to take some hydrogen peroxide, place it in the well, Now, hydrogen peroxide decomposes over time, but we're going to speed up that reaction by adding a catalyst, which in this case we're going to add some manganese dioxide. Okay, moving on to station 7, we are going to do solid iron plus copper 2 sulfate. So this one will be a bit tricky to see. You can kind of see the color change occurring. So based off of the products that you've predicted, this change in color should be pretty expected. You can kind of see if I was to just try to stir it around a bit. Make sure all the iron can get reacted. Moving on to station 8, where we're going to add copper 2 nitrate to sodium phosphate. There's that classic blue color of a copper solution. And here comes sodium phosphate. So that's a pretty neat reaction. And this is actually a solid that has just formed. You can kind of see. Okay. We'll keep moving on here. So we're going to do magnesium plus nitric acid. Watch carefully. And try to predict what gas is forming there. So that reaction also will take a bit of time. We'll move on to our last station, this one is copper, and we're going to plus it by silver nitrate. This is a pretty cool reaction. So, you can see the parts that have been exposed to the silver nitrate have changed color quite quickly. Now, based off of our knowledge of single displacement reactions, you should be able to predict exactly what solid is forming and coating itself on the copper metal. There you have it. So, You can see that this was a pretty informative and nice visual experience when it comes to chemical reactions, the different types of chemical reactions. The goal of this was to give you a more of an insight into exactly how double displacement, single displacement, synthesis, and decomposition behave and how they look.